Hey everyone! In this video, we're going to be walking through a backwards different method example. The backwards different method is a numerical technique commonly used to approximate derivatives of a function. It's a simple yet effective numerical technique that can be applied to various scenarios. If you missed our past video on the theory behind the backwards different method, I will leave a link in the description down below for you to check out. After that video, you should have a strong understanding of what this method is, how to use it, and why we learn about the backwards different method. Let's get into the first problem now. We are given the function f of x equals x squared. We are asked to approximate the derivative of this function at x equals 2, using the backwards different method. We are also told to use a step size of 0.05. Let's begin by graphing our given function and then writing out the formula for the backwards different method that we developed in the previous video. We say that the derivative of our function is approximately equal to the finite difference between the two function outputs divided by a designated step size. Now, all we need to do is evaluate our function at two points. Let's evaluate our function x squared at 2 and 2 minus our step size, which is 1.95. Now, plugging in all our required variables, we receive that the derivative is approximately equal to 3.95. As we learned in our last video, our error is going to be proportional to the step size that we take. Therefore, to reduce the amount of error that we get, let's try taking a smaller step size and see if our answer is more accurate. Now, let's assume a step size of 0.01. Doing so, our f of xi will remain the same. We just need to recalculate xi minus 1, which is going to be evaluated at 1.99, and this results in 3.96. Recall from our previous video that we said that the error is proportional to our step size. Well, that is clear here. We've reduced our step size, and our error decreased. Next, let's complete a more challenging problem. In this example, we are asked to use the backward difference method to find the derivative of e to the x times sine x over x for an input of 0.5 and a step size of 0.05. Well, although our function may not be fun to solve analytically, in the past, let's note how easy and quick it is to find the derivative with numerical differentiation. So, we'll just evaluate our function at 0.5 and 0.45 first, just like we did before. Now, we can plug these values into our backwards difference equation, and we find that the derivative at 0.5 of this function is approximately 1.299. Quickly, let's check how accurate this answer is. To do this, we need to first take the derivative of the function, simplify it, and then evaluate x at 0.5. Doing so, we get that this function's derivative at 0.5 is 1.3129, which is quite close to our approximated value. As you can see, using numerical differentiation is incredibly powerful. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to implement the backwards difference method to solve examples. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.